Normalement, je pense que
Yes.
je vais le voir aussi.
Hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. I hope you're all safe and ready for spending good time together for the next hour. So I'm in confinement in Paris, and I hope it's the same for you everything is good in good shape for so far. And I know lots of people are asking me to speak a little bit in French, and it's what I'll do at the end of this session. For a few minutes, I will do a bit in French. Et donc, je dis bonjour à tous les fans et amis français qui sont aussi dans mon cas, donc confinés chez eux. J'espère que vous allez bien. Et j'étais en train de dire justement en anglais, ce que vous avez peut-être dû comprendre, que je dédierai les quelques minutes en fin de conversation, de session, en français pour répondre à toutes les questions aussi que vous me parlez, pour résumer, que vous me posez, pardon, et aussi pour résumer un peu ce qu'on s'est dit. Voilà. Il y a énormément de questions. There is a lot of questions from Twitter and Facebook, and I'm going to try within the next hour to answer to all your questions. But I would like to start by explaining why I decided to do a Facebook Live. Last time I said that I would like to have this kind of recurrent rendezvous with you all every 3 months, and we are already in March, and I thought it was the right time to do it. There is another reason. The 17th of March today is a very special day, because it's the moment where Apple has declared Aeon as the app of the day in 123 countries. And of course, I'm very happy, and we're all very happy about this. And and also it's the day where we are launching the V2, or it's 1.3, but anyway, it's the V2 of the Aeon app, with lot of improvements, with total different menu. The menu has been improved. Also with lot of new music and new graphics, and also one very interesting new item called Share Your Aeon Moments. I'm going to explain you what it is in a minute, but I would like to say that I'm not forgetting, and we're not forgetting at all our friends and all the questions about the Android version. Let me talk to you about this. We are working hard, and the Bliss team is working hard at the moment to release the Android version as soon as possible. It's more difficult than we thought to transpose the grammar of the iOS world into the Android one. But it's going to happen. It takes time. It takes quite lots of adaptation, and we are all working on it. And believe me, I'm totally conscious of the problem. And of course, we respect all the Android family. Having said that, you know, in the world of music, is most of the time in studios, and in the way we are working in studios, much more an Apple world than Android world. This is the reason why so many apps and so many different plugins are developed also for the iOS world. And it's not because I prefer, or I would prefer one world than another. And I'm actually an Apple guy. I'm not that much an Android guy. This is the way it is, and I know that a lot of people in the graphic world, for instance, would be maybe more in the Android world, but it's what is the way it is. So I hope that, and I've sorry for keep you waiting, Android, the Android tribe, and but of course, I'm so excited by what Aeon is becoming now, and I would like to talk to you about this, because I have lots of questions about it, and I know that you have lots of questions to about the future of Aeon. So to lots of questions about that, so to answer globally to all these questions, I would say that this new version of the urn, just being released today, is a major improvement from the last one. First of all, because as I said, we have now the possibility of record 48 seconds. Why 48 seconds? It's because the old philosophy of this recording process is, I mean, being called share your urn moments, is actually to get the overall BPM of urn is 120. It makes that 48 seconds is exactly 24 bars, whatever you do. And it could be 12 bars, 24 bars, or 48, depending on the speed. But it's always something that will create a good segment, musically speaking, rhythmically speaking. And then also, most of the time, we like to share our moments of life on Instagram. And as we know, it's like a 1 minute sequence or 48 seconds appeared to us something quite cool to share. And these 48 seconds, what's quite cool, what I like in this idea is actually you always record the next 48 seconds, the next minute. So you never know exactly what you are going to record. And it goes with the philosophy of urn that each time you start the urn, you never know what's going to happen. And it's really what I like in this whole project. As I said, it's like a moment, moments in life where you have like the moment we are sharing together will not going to happen again. It's what I like in the old philosophy of urn and in the philosophy of share your urn moment. And I hope that will be you will be a lot to share your favorite moments. And I really have in mind the fact that maybe by the end, maybe few times in a year, maybe to publish my favorite moments of yours, the moments maybe doing a top 10 of my favorite moments that you will publish on Instagram, and maybe doing a special top 10 of the year where the winners could have some goodies or some good surprises. So this is part of the improvement. The other one is also, of course, rate your app, your Ian app, if you like it, if you don't like it. Why? Because it's always interesting to know your reactions and to improve this whole project. Because as I told you from the beginning, for me this project is Ian for me is like a living creature, and you can see with this new version that it's actually a new evolvement, and for me Ian is a kind of is in constant evolution. The next version will be different. The graphics will be different. The music is going to evolve. And to answer to some of the questions to J.P. Gejati, for instance, and lots of other, saying, what about your Ian Live project? Actually, I'm working on the idea of having a Ian Live version. I don't know yet at that time how it's going to be, because I'm working on it, of course. To create a dialogue with Ian should be, of course, different than the app, of course. And we are working quite a lot at the moment, and starting to work actually with the Bliss team to try to define a kind of system for me to be able to perform this Ian project. And also, I'm going to start in the next few days and weeks to think about also the visuals. So I will keep you posted on this. I would like also to talk to you about what happened to me the past few weeks, because I've been involved, as you know probably, about a fantastic project in Alula, in the desert of Arabia. And it was a project, I worked on this project for the past few weeks and even months with all my usual crew. And I must say that it has been an extraordinary adventure for different reasons. First of all, because this fantastic UNESCO World Heritage Site is absolutely unique, is like a Petra of Arabia, you know, the famous place that you suddenly saw in Indiana Jones, you know, this kind of tombs, I mean, really excavation in the rocks. So it was a tribute of these fantastic rocks in the middle of the desert. And also I worked really hard on the very interesting stage design, very, very high tech. And this whole thing was, I thought a lot by working on this project about the Close Encounters of the Third Kind. You know, this famous scene when the people are climbing on the mount and then suddenly they discover this kind of base space station. And the whole project was based on this kind of contrast between an organic landscape with this kind of very high-tech stage. And this whole project has been produced by Vice, and I must say that I've been really impressed and thrilled to work with such a great team. And Vice has shot a film documentary, and this film documentary should be ready probably in May, June, and being released in the probably now with all what's going on with the virus. We don't know exactly in terms of of schedule what's going to happen this year, but it should be ready for before the end of the year. And I'm very looking very impatient and looking forward to sharing all this great adventure with you all. And actually, I performed during this concert a new track called Azimuth, because as a tribute to the place. And this is also something I will be very happy to share with you. So we are in confinement, and Marie-Laure, you know Marie-Laure, she's also at her home, and she's through Skype, and I she's also following constantly because the new questions coming, and sometimes you will hear her voice. Because sometimes she has new questions coming in, and so you know we are at the same in all gathered we are all together, but as we know each of us are especially in France, in Italy, in Spain, I mean confined in confinement in our homes or studios, and actually is is the situation I'm in at the moment, since 12 noon in France today. We all have the obligation to stay at home, as you probably know. So, lots of questions about the next studio album. I see Marie-Laure. You're making some signs. So, Marie-Laure, yeah. What do you want to say?
I would like to say that people are also asking, would it be possible to have a private gig because of the confinement? It should be a good idea. and hello from both countries, like Scotland, Houston, Poland, England, and so. And also, thinking about a tour in 2021.
Okay, so actually, the idea of a live gig on Facebook or on the internet one of these days is a very good idea. It's only because if we are still in confinement for the next few weeks because we don't know exactly how long we are going to be stuck in this situation. I will suddenly come to the idea to just improvise from the studio for in one night or something like this. And of course, we'll let you know if such a project comes along, of course, we'll let you know. Yes, Marie.
What about Electronica 3?
Yes, so lots of questions about Electronica 3 from Gonzalo Schaffer Canobra, from lots of people also on Twitter. And this Electronica 3 is on the way. I've been really working on the development of Eon also for this Alula project, but I'm going to start now the Electronica 3, but it's not going to be released before 2021, but I'm going to work on the project right now in the next few weeks.
And what about a new tour, world tour or European tour? Would it be possible?
So, talking about the tour, you have lots of questions about touring, and I'm quite interested by this Eon Live project, and I really would like to do it and to do a few dates this year in 2020, by the end of 2020. Now it's all depending on the new situation with the virus and what's going to happen in the next few weeks. As you know, we are going through, everybody's going through a very, very difficult time, but of course all the sector of music, shows, theater, and all linked to the cultural events, exhibitions, all that, are in a very hard situation. And I would like to say that I have special thoughts about all my colleagues, musicians, technicians, and people being involved in so many great festivals and concerts, and they're all cancelled. And it's, of course, a big financial issue for them, and also a big disappointment for the audience and for the people who already booked some tickets. So I have really, of course, a very special thought about all of them, and I hope that this terrible virus we are going to win against this virus as quickly as possible. But for that, we have to obey the rules. I've been quite shocked the past few days, for instance, in Paris, to see people, I mean, just hanging around in parks and in the street, like if it was holidays, because we had a sunny weekend in Paris. And I think it's terrible because people don't understand and don't realize the gravity and how bad this virus can be. So, but the other good thing for if we are in good health is actually we can stay at home and doing some music, and also I've been very lucky because I have a few questions about new synth, and I must say that I've been very interested by new synthesizers. Since the last time we talked, and I would like to talk to you about them, because I've been really happy that now we're not able to receive anything. And this morning, I just received two synths I was waiting for. One is the new Pro 3 from Dave Smith, which is a very interesting synth. It's actually, I can even show it to you. This. And it's quite an interesting, and you see Dave Smith is always doing very interesting synthesizer. I know another one is the Synthrex by this fantastic small company called Erika Synth, that all Eurorack users are familiar with. And they did this fantastic It's a, not a clone, but I would say it's the what I was waiting for the, since I'm 18 years old is a, is an AKS with presets, with a digital matrix. And this is something absolutely extraordinary, and I'm so excited. It was Christmas today when I received them, both these, and by total coincidence, this this morning. Marie-Laure, you wanted to add something?
Yes, I have another question about collaborators and about the new musician you have on stage during Alula.
Okay, so I just wanted to finish before answering to these questions to the new synthesizers. I have, of course, a special thanks to Korg, because I received also the fantastic ARP 2600, my legendary synth since the early 70s. And I must say that I've been absolutely amazed, because I forgot what is the feeling of having a kind of modular like this, brand new. It's all shiny and brand new. And I'm really excited, and it's a very interesting very interesting synth, of course. At this, so I have, in the next few days and nights, I'm going to spend lots of time with these new toys. And I will let you know more when I'll be working with them. So, Marie-Laure, you were saying...
Yeah, collaborators and the new musician you have on stage during Alula.
Yes, so during Alula, I have been really thrilled. For quite a long time, I wanted to work with a female musician, and it never really worked and through the years. And then I've got the opportunity to meet a really an extraordinary person as a musician, but also as a person. She's Japanese, and her name is Narumi, and she's a very good of course keyboard player, and she went into the whole family and the whole team in a very easy way and clever way, and she worked so hard to give the best possible performance in the desert. For her, it was a premiere, and it always difficult to dive into a new music for her, even if she's familiar of my music, and also with a new team like this. And I must say that I'm absolutely delighted about this collaboration, and of course we are going to work together if she wants in the future. But I think we suddenly felt as a band really for with Claude and Narumi and myself on stage. So about the collaborations, apart from the collaborations with the musicians working with me on stage, I have, of course, I'm not going to reveal any names today, because the principle of the project as Electronica 3 is actually to also create the surprise of the collaborations, and not to reveal. It would be also I think not right regarding the people I'm discussing at the moment with. I prefer to wait until we have finished tracks to reveal some collaborators. But I can tell you that it's going to be fairly different from Electronica 1 and 2 in terms of collaborations, because I don't like to repeat myself. And I'm really into working in a total different directions in terms of collaborations. So Marie-Laure, because actually suddenly Marie-Laure has all the questions in front of her, and so it's much easier for her to tell me.
One word about the book tour, if there is any.
Yes, another project for the 2020 is a fairly busy year for me, because I'm working on lots of different things, and of course also preparing the release of my autobiography, the book in English, and hopefully at the same time in German and Spanish. and for the other language probably later on. But we are working hard to make this release possible for also October, and doing probably a book tour, ideally accompanied with some concerts linked with the Ian Live project. So, yes, some other things?
T-shirt. What is this new T-shirt?
Actually, this T-shirt is a T-shirt we did for Alula, and it's a new logo I would like to develop, and it's I really like it. I hope you like it as well, because it's, for a long time we were looking for a JMJ logo. And then by looking about different things with my friend Eric Kornick, I mean, as you know, we are working together for a long time for record covers and lots of graphic projects. We went into this work in progress. It's still work in progress, but I like it a lot. You know, it's very funny because you know it's JMJ, but it could be a lots of other things also, and it could be also like a sci-fi type of logo. It could be a kind of Japanese character or Arabic character, or also it could be a character from Game of Thrones or Star Trek. So I really like it. And then I was wearing this for the first time for the on stage in the desert.
Another question, coming back to Alula, lots of people would like to know when it would be possible to listen to Azimuth.
That would be part of this release of the live the film, because it was because as I said, what makes this project very special, the Alula project, is the Azimuth, during the Azimuth Festival, so called. It was not actually purely a concert with an audience, like a festival at the beginning, even if it became more or less like this, but it was more the shooting, a little bit like Pink Floyd, the Pompeii, for people who knows this project, Pink Floyd project in the 70s, and where we were going to an extraordinary place, building a stage, doing some music, and building this an extraordinary stage design, and then disappearing the following morning, witnessed by an audience. So the audience was not that big, and it's important to understand that going into the middle of the desert is a real adventure. So it was much more like a camp, like a kind of Burning Man, but one day and one time. So it was not a project thought for welcoming audience. It was more a music project being produced in order to be filmed, where the audience would be more like a witnesses and witnessing an event. And this is what it is, and we of course you will have a lot of you will be able to watch lots of visuals and images before the end of 2020 about it.
Alors là, j'ai une demande express de pas mal de gens, c'est pour ça que je le dis en français, qui demande. Est-ce qu'il serait possible d'avoir une rapide traduction de tout ce qui vient de se dire, même si on a dit qu'au début il y aurait une traduction à la fin, un résumé. Mais là,
okay. As Marie-Laure is speaking in French, you understand that there is a lot of frustration about people following this whole session in live in being French and not really understanding English. So to be fair, I'm going to talk in French for just a few minutes, going back to English, and by the end of the session also finishing in French. Je suis ravi aussi de pouvoir vous parler en français et résumer un petit peu ce que je viens de dire. J'ai la raison de ce Facebook Live, Il y en a plusieurs. La première, c'est que j'avais promis la dernière fois que on se reverrait à peu près tous les 3 mois, ce que je fais aujourd'hui. Et aujourd'hui, le 17 mars, est un jour très particulier puisque c'est le lancement de la nouvelle version de Aeon, qui est accompagnée par une grande campagne faite par Apple, puisque aujourd'hui, Aeon est l'appli du jour dans 123 pays. Et je suis très honoré et très touché par cette décision d'Apple de mettre en avant Aeon. Ça compte beaucoup pour moi, comme vous le savez, pour l'équipe qui travaille autour de ce projet, notamment Bliss. Et c'est une version, donc, et on en profite pour lancer justement la version numéro 2, si on peut dire, qui est même si elle s'appelle 1.3. C'est la version, pour moi, la version numéro 2 depuis la première, qui est toujours une version qui est développée sur iOS. Et je voudrais dire à tous nos amis qui sont sur Android qu'on travaille très dur pour arriver à sortir la version Android, mais que c'est assez compliqué techniquement. Ça prend plus de temps que prévu. Donc si ça ne sort pas aujourd'hui, ce n'est pas parce qu'on le néglige et que je m'en fous. C'est pas du tout ça. C'est que techniquement, ça pose un certain nombre de problèmes. Donc on va essayer de le résoudre le plus rapidement possible. Mais ça n'empêche pas de pouvoir continuer, pour moi, artistiquement, à développer ce projet qui est né sous iOS, simplement pour une raison simple, c'est que, comme vous le savez sans doute, le monde de la musique est plus un monde Apple qu'un monde Android. Simplement parce qu'il y a souvent le monde graphique, visuel, travaille plus sous PC, et le monde de la musique est souvent un peu plus sous Apple. Et que moi, je suis un Apple Kid, beaucoup plus depuis le départ. Je travaille moi que sur Apple, et donc naturellement, on s'est dirigé dans cette direction-là. Mais je n'oublie pas du tout, évidemment, toutes vos demandes par rapport à Android, et je vous promets que le plus vite possible, on va essayer de sortir Aeon sur Android. Simplement quelques mots pour vous dire par rapport à cette version, pour justement ceux qui peuvent la télécharger et en profiter. Ce qu'il y a de différent, c'est que d'une part, il y a énormément de. Je vois qu'il y a de la lumière qui est en train de s'éteindre, mais bon, c'est pas bien grave. En fait, les grandes nouveautés, c'est d'abord esthétiquement, le menu a beaucoup évolué. J'aimais pas beaucoup cette espèce de rectangle noir un peu pierre tombale qui était vraiment la première version. Donc, je voulais vraiment la changer. Donc, quelque chose de beaucoup plus esthétique. Le fond maintenant est le fond graphique d'Eon. Et puis, il y a différentes. Il y a aussi beaucoup de. La qualité musicale s'est améliorée. Il y a beaucoup de moments musicaux aussi, de nouvelles musiques que j'ai ajoutées. Aussi sur le plan visuel, sur le plan graphique, il y a eu pas mal d'évolutions. Et puis surtout, il y a une nouvelle fonction qui s'appelle Share Your Aeon Moments, c'est-à-dire partager votre moment Aeon, qui en fait vous permet d'enregistrer la minute qui va suivre, plus exactement les 48 secondes qui vont suivre. C'est-à-dire, pourquoi 48 secondes? C'est qu'en fait, comme le BPM général d'Eon repose sur 120 BPM, même si à certains moments on est plus lent à 60 ou deux fois plus rapide à 240, d'une certaine manière, on est toujours sur je dirais, une déclinaison de mesure. Et donc 48 secondes, ça fait 24 mesures à 120, ou ça fait 48 mesures ou 12 mesures à 60, 48 mesures etc. Et donc du coup, on est toujours sûr d'enregistrer quelque chose de cohérent musicalement. Et ce Share Your Moments va vous permettre de pouvoir publier sur Instagram, puisque l'Instagram ne prend justement qu'un maximum d'une minute, va pouvoir vous permettre de partager vos moments favoris. Et je voudrais bien faire un top 10 plusieurs fois par an de vos moments que j'ai préférés. Et peut-être à la fin de l'année, faire une sorte de top 10 avec des gagnants sur ceux qui m'auront le plus plu. Je trouve que c'est une bonne idée de la manière en fait d'interagir entre nous. Et aussi, ce que j'aime beaucoup par rapport à ce Share Your Moment, c'est qu'en fait, vous allez toujours enregistrer la minute qui arrive. Et ça va avec cette idée d'Eon depuis le départ de ne pas d'être d'être dans le présent. C'est-à-dire, comme je l'ai déjà dit, ce moment qu'on vit, on ne le revivra plus de la même manière. Donc on va le vivre, on en fera d'autres, mais ce moment-là qu'on partage ensemble sur Facebook, on ne le retrouvera pas. C'est exactement la même chose pour Eon. Tout ce qu'on entend, comme vous avez compris, pour ceux qui l'ont téléchargé, tout ce qu'on écoute, tout ce qu'on entend ne se reproduira pas. C'est la même chose pour le Share Eon Moments, parce qu'à chaque fois que vous allez enregistrer, vous ne saurez jamais ce qui va se passer. Donc vous l'aimerez ou pas, donc vous pourrez le jeter ou le garder, et puis finalement, au fil du temps, vous dire, bah, tiens, celui-là, je l'aime bien, je vais le poster. Voilà l'idée. L'autre chose dont on a parlé aussi, c'est qu'il y a aussi le fait de pouvoir rate your appli, c'est-à-dire de pouvoir mettre une étoile à celle qu'on aime. Ça permet aussi pour moi de savoir où j'en suis, de savoir comment vous situez, si vous aimez votre expérience ou pas, et de pouvoir l'améliorer aussi. Puisque pour moi, comme vous l'avez compris, cette appli est une appli qui est en constante progression, en constante évolution. En parlant d'évolution d'Eon, comme je le disais aussi en anglais, j'ai l'intention de pouvoir porter Eon sur scène et je vais commencer à travailler maintenant. Avec cette idée de pouvoir dialoguer, probablement en solo, sur scène, avec Eon. Et donc pour ça, je vais travailler, et bien sûr, ce ne sera pas la même version que la version de l'appli, mais de trouver quelque chose qui puisse justement avoir du sens et qui soit quelque chose de nouveau. J'ai envie d'expérimenter quelque chose de complètement différent sur scène, aussi bien sur le plan musical que sur le plan visuel. Ce qui est mon projet de scène pour 2020. Voilà. Et on a parlé aussi très rapidement d'Electronica 3. Je commence à travailler dessus. Il n'y a rien de nouveau par rapport à ça. Je ne vais pas révéler les collaborations avec lesquelles que je vais faire par respect vis-à-vis des gens qui sont pas encore mis au travail. Mais évidemment, vous le saurez au fur et à mesure. C'est un peu le jeu d'un projet comme celui-là, puisque je voudrais sortir des titres les uns derrière les autres. Voilà, et sinon, en anglais, on avait parlé de Marie-Laure. Oui, j'ai parlé aussi très brièvement des nouveaux synthés que j'ai reçus et sur lesquels je vais travailler, le Pro 3, le Pro 3 de Dave Smith, le Synthrex de Erika Synth, et puis évidemment la RP 2600 de Korg, qui est une beauté que j'ai reçu de la direction japonaise de Korg, et c'est un grand honneur parce que je connaissais bien le père de Monsieur Kato, le fondateur de Korg, et j'étais très touché de recevoir cette pièce de musée aujourd'hui et de voir un ARP brillant et tout neuf. Ce que j'avais oublié, ce que c'était qu'un modulaire analogique comme ça, tout neuf. Donc c'est un grand plaisir et je vais profiter de ce moment de confinement pour mettre les mains dessus. Voilà. Et puis, quelqu'un m'a posé la question de savoir si, dans ces moments de confinement, ça serait pas bien de faire éventuellement un live sur Facebook ou un live sur Internet. Pourquoi pas, si le confinement dure. C'est quelque chose, peut-être qu'un jour, je ferai peut-être, où je pourrais improviser et vous retrouver à un moment donné. Voilà. Je retourne en anglais. Thank you for your patience for all the people who don't understand our local dialect. So I wanted to also to I mean, one comment about Ian is actually in days where we are in this confinement situation in lots of countries, the internet speed is reduced, the internet is saturated, as you know, because lots of people, students, are using the internet, and for people is the only way to get a contact with the outside world. I think rather to go to Spotify, listen to Eon, because it's offline and it's a very clever way to get some music without using your Wi-Fi. Of course, in a sense, talking about this confinement and rather dark moment we are all going through. In a sense, today I was thinking that music like Ion, being able to be always different for 2 weeks, for 4 weeks, for 6 weeks, and even even beyond, is my contribution to, I would say, the electro of confinement. And I think it's quite fun to approach Ion also in these days in that way. I think somehow it, I hope that it could help people to, as somebody said very nicely about the boredom. Who is this? I saw that.
It's Dragon Scale.
Yes,
I will watch.
Yes, Dragon Scale. Dragon Scale, you said something. I will watch to fight boredom. How are you managing the quarantine? Me putting things to sell, making music, and sending job offers. It's. I think, you know, listening to Ion, I hope that it will contribute Dragon Scale and other people to fight boredom. So to go back to some of your other questions, some questions were about the price, of in general. It's not negative, but saying why not doing, for instance, during the this moment, during having Ion for free. And it's a very interesting question, because it's a good opportunity for me to talk about the value of creativity. You know, it's something that I'm really fighting for. You know, nobody protests about buying a T-shirt or a pair of sneakers or a pair of shoes for 100 euros when the cost of these items are sometimes not higher than 1 euro or 2 euros. And because it's an object, everybody thinks it's natural to pay a pair of shoes for 100 euros or $100. And but when suddenly we are talking about music or movies or an app and selling and having this app for 9 euros or even 15 euros, people are saying, but it's so expensive. And I think, you know, it's absolutely unfair. And I'm to tell you the truth, I'm quite shocked about that. When I see people spending hours, days and nights to try to create something absolutely new, original, such as Ion, but such as lots of other apps, and then being criticized because they just want to survive and work and get their decent living about their work. I think there is something wrong in all this, and I really take this opportunity to tell you that I rely on you to try to promote this idea that you know, every work has a value, and creative, most of the time, because it's instant, you can download an app instantly. You say, okay, it's available, so it has no value. It has a great value when you see all these plugins for music, for instance, all these fantastic plugins you have, all these fantastic synth, like so many great synth, like the one that actually Bliss just released recently. I mean, it's, you know, it's a month of development where people just working in a project in which they believe, with no even commercial ambition. So the least we can say is actually, if we are interested, is to pay for it and to pay the right price. So having said that, going back to your question,
yes.
You were so Marie-Laure is constantly bombarded by new questions. So Marie-Laure, yeah. What else?
Lots of questions about release of concert on Blu-ray or something like that. Do you think it should be possible in the next future?
So this year, I really would like to release something based on the live. On my live activities, as I told you, this idea of releasing some concert part of the catalog, I would say, is on the pipeline in discussion with Sony for quite a while, and it will happen. But it's not going to happen this year, because this year I would like to to release some live material, probably based on my recent work, based on Electronica tour, based on the Alula fantastic project. I have so many interesting visuals and footage that I would like to share with you in the best possible quality. And also DVD, Blu-ray are interesting, but also VOD is interesting. And it's something that I really would like to explore in the next few years, of course.
And I would like to apologize because some German fans and friends are sending their question in German and also in Spanish. And unfortunately, I can't translate everything, so it's a pity, but that's life. Lots of questions in German and Spanish.
Yeah, and in also different languages. So we're sorry about that, but in the next few days we'll try to catch up and see if there is questions in different languages not part of the questions already asked in English, and I'll answer to some of those questions through Facebook or Twitter, right?
Yeah,
So,
and a
yeah.
very personal question from Bülent Orhan, and he's asking you when are you coming to Turkey?
Yes, so you have a lot we have a lot of questions of people from all over the world asking me when I'm going to visit your country. What I can promise is I'm going to do my best to play Turkey, to go back to Chile, to go to Australia, to go to Russia, to China, to Japan. To lots of people are asking me questions, and as you understand, a world tour and especially these days, a world tour is something that is not easy to put together. And also, I don't want to tour for just the sake of touring. I would like to share with you something interesting in terms of on a musical point of view, on a stage point of view. And I know that lots of people would like to meet just to play my hits, Rendezvous, Magnetic Fields, and Oxygen, and Equinox. Of course, it's interesting. On an artistic point of view, to tell you the truth, it's not necessarily you have artists who are fine with this. I'm not necessarily fine with this. I would be very happy to do it, and I will do it in the future. But also, it's interesting also to come with a new project. It's like a writer or a filmmaker, a director would repeat the same movie, and forever. After a while, it's a bit boring for everybody. And having said that, so as you understand, my next stage project will not be necessarily based on best of or greatest hits type of project, but more something new. And but having said that, of course, I promise that I will go to Turkey, to South America, to lots of countries I've not been enough, and as soon as possible, and also to continue to go to countries such as Saudi Arabia or eventually North Korea or some other countries. As I told you last time, it's very important to me to go in countries where people don't have access to the same kind of freedom and access to culture as we have, as we do. I consider culture as I said last time, a Trojan horse. Of course, with people, if you take the Saudi Arabia, you know, 60% of the population is under 30 years old. And they need music, they need movies, they need us. And I think that an artist has to make the difference between ideology and the people. It's something that, as I told you, and it's something I'm mentioning in my book also, that people in French have read already. My mom told me when I was a kid, to not mixing ideology and the people, not in the during the war, for instance, not mixing the Nazi and German people, not the same thing. And it's what we should, and I want to do in my life. And this is the reason why I will continue to go to some countries where people don't have access to music as we do in our own countries. So, yes, Marie-Laure.
Yes. Do you imagine a collaboration with NASA?
So, you know, a collaboration with NASA, as you probably know, is something I've done already. It was for Houston, and I have fantastic memories and recollections about that, working with the astronauts for this crazy project of doing some music in space and playing music in space. And even it was linked to the Challenger's tragedy, as you probably heard about, and where the project never happened because of the, and then the Houston concert became a tribute to the astronaut. It's of course something unforgettable for me, and I would like to I would be very happy to of course to work again with NASA, but also maybe to people linked with space these days, and you have lots of different actors linked with link with space. And also I would be also quite interested to I'm quite involved, as you know, in environment, and I'm really looking forward to find a solution to about carbon footprint. It's something that I have really in mind for my next concert, and even what we are calculating at the moment in Alula, for instance, is to get the to balance the carbon footprint each time I'm doing something. So in the future, I'm going really to, we are starting at the moment to think about what with the best solutions. I know that other artists are thinking about the same direction, and I think it's quite important also to be responsible. It's not about only planting trees, because it's apparently it's not the best solution, but to try to globally, having a global vision, to try to compensate and to reset what we are spending in terms of CO2, and to try to balance that. So it's also something I'm working quite a lot with UNESCO and with my team to try to find a solution for the future.
Yes. Do you have any plan to explore VR?
Yes, thank you for asking. I saw that yours are asking about VR, and I don't remember. I saw some. I would like to answer directly to yes. Unique Alien is asking me, would be awesome to if you held a concert in VR, and lots of other questions about that. Yes, definitely. I'm very involved in VR, as you know. I'm working into this project of setting a VR studio, a virtual studio, where I could, with my avatar, working inside a virtual place. And what's interesting, it's not only just fun. Is what's very interesting is actually you can work and collaborate with somebody live in the same virtual place, and this person could be I could be in France and he could be in California, for instance, and we could be together with no latency in the same virtual place, and this space could be then an instant place of creation, and at the same time being a place for performance, and inviting other people like you into this VR moment. That is going to be to explode, in my opinion, this when we'll get rid of the antennas and the rather heavy equipment required at the moment. For instance, the new Oculus glass without computers and all built in is of course an evolution, and some other companies are working on that. And I think that as soon as we have this kind of equipment, I think it will be really possible to work much more and to develop really relevant concept and ideas around the VR world. But of course, it's, as you know, probably is something that I'm very, very involved with. And I had to cancel my trip to America. I should be actually today at South by Southwest to present the new Eon version in America, in the States, and also for discussing about being part of a panel about AI and music. And unfortunately, because of the virus, all this has been cancelled. And then I was supposed to stay in California for a few weeks to also work on different projects, and especially also to develop some VR aspect of my coming project. So yes, absolutely, the VR world is part of my future, and I hope to share it with you ASAP.
And do you think you will be able to make something between Aeon and VR together?
Yes, I saw that some questions are about also this idea of mixing Aeon and VR. Why not? It's I think, you know, VR is going to be a language, a common language in the future, and I think that all my projects will be necessarily linked with VR when like AI, you know, it's the same thing. AI is touchy. Aeon, the beauty of Aeon for me is actually linked with lots of different techniques these days. First of all, of course, the world of algorithm, and later on also pure artificial intelligence algorithm, and also the world of VR by actually transpose what the philosophy of Aeon, meaning a world in constant development. Let's imagine a world in constant development in VR. That the VR is the right grammar or the right world for expressing a world in continuous development. As we know, for people who are interested in video games, you have for even almost 10, 15 years, even more, some video games based on this idea of constant evolutive type of world and universe. So of course, that would be part of the Aeon development in the future.
Do you have in mind to...
So one guy is saying, stop talking about working about VR Aeon, but when a collaboration with Vangelis? I mean, I just missed you, your name, because it's constantly moving. And I see Thomas that you are quite obsessed by this collaboration. You know, ask Vangelis. I'm not against the idea, but actually Vangelis is doing less and less music at the moment. He's doing his own project, and of course, if he agrees, I would be very happy to work with him. It's more his decision than mine.
This guy was Thomas Nolin.
So Thomas, you can ask Vangelis. I know that he was seriously. He was. I know he was. He was a bit not in very good shape recently. He was a bit tired and not doing a lot of music. And I've, as you know, lots of respect for his music, and I would be delighted to work with him, of course, one of these days. I also saw some people talking about Michael Field, and this is something I really would like to do. I know that Mike made some very positive comment about a potential collaboration, so I really would like this to happen in the future. And then if you start to say, and Brian Eno, and this and that, of course, I love all these great artists, and, you know, This is the reason why I decided to develop this electronica project on the side, in parallel of my studio albums, is actually to have the opportunity to meet with these great artists and to try to do something different from what they do and what I'm doing. So that would be great. And so let me finalize Electronica 3, and I hope that some of the next collaborations will make you less frustrated. Let's put it like this.
The last question, maybe?
Yes.
Do you have in mind to create a synth at your name?
A what?
A synth, a synthesizer.
Ah, yes, I would be very interested to develop some synthesizer and some plugins, and something that I really, and actually, to reveal you a little secret, we are discussing with Bliss about joining forces to try to conceive something, because I have for a long time I've in mind to develop some synthesizers I have in mind that I can't find anywhere, and I would like to use my own experience and to try to create something really different from what it is and what I don't find, actually. So in a sense, this synth will be very interesting, because it will be a selfish project, and then by definition I hope that it would be interesting for other people. So I think I would like to go back to French to finish this Facebook session, and I will, of course, ending by saying goodbye in English to all of you. Ce dont je parlais en anglais ces derniers moments, ça a été effectivement le. Ça a été. On a. J'ai parlé effectivement de l'idée de travailler avec la réalité virtuelle, avec le monde du VR. Et j'ai commencé à le faire avec Aquinox Infinity. Et c'est évidemment par rapport à Aeon quelque chose que je voudrais développer. Et notamment aussi en dehors de Aeon, cette idée de studio virtuel, c'est-à-dire de pouvoir, avec mon avatar, venir à l'intérieur d'un endroit virtuel et de pouvoir inviter d'autres gens qui pourraient venir avec leur propre avatar. Au-delà, c'est pas juste un truc cool et amusant qui se rapproche d'un jeu vidéo, c'est simplement quelque chose qui serait très intéressant, puisqu'on pourrait imaginer que. Je peux être moi ici à Paris et quelqu'un peut être en Californie ou au Japon, et qu'on puisse travailler ensemble dans le même lieu, sans latence, simplement avec nos avatars. Et que ce lieu de création, finalement, puisse aussi être un lieu de performance et un lieu où on puisse faire des concerts sur Internet. On pourrait imaginer aujourd'hui si... aujourd'hui, la réalité virtuelle sur le plan de l'équipement n'est pas suffisamment développée. On est encore bloqué avec les antennes, avec un équipement assez cher. Donc, on n'est pas arrivé encore à quelque chose qui puisse être suffisamment développé en termes de marché. Mais c'est quelque chose qui va se développer très rapidement, notamment avec les nouvelles lunettes du type nouvelle génération d'Oculus, où on n'a plus besoin, tout est autonome, et on n'a plus besoin d'ordi, de laptop ou d'antenne. Donc ça, je pense que c'est quelque chose qui va arriver rapidement, et c'est évidemment quelque chose sur lequel je voudrais beaucoup travailler, notamment pour Aeon, puisque Aeon est quelque chose qui est un concept qui est en constante évolution. Donc la réalité virtuelle se prête particulièrement à des mondes en constante évolution. Dans les jeux vidéo, on sait tous que depuis des années, il y a justement des jeux vidéo qui sont liés sur le fait d'explorer et de construire un univers propre qui est en constant développement, ce qui est un peu ce qui est tout à fait le cas de Aeon. Donc oui, c'est quelque chose qui m'intéresse beaucoup. On a aussi couvert le fait de parler de collaborations diverses et variées, que ce soit avec Vangelis, avec Mike Oldfield, avec Brian Eno. Bien sûr que je serais tout à fait heureux de travailler avec eux. Il faut aussi leur demander leur avis. Bien sûr, c'est des choses qui seront, de mon côté en tout cas, tout à fait ouvertes et qui serait tout à fait plus qu'acceptable, et je serais absolument heureux de pouvoir. Et c'est la raison pour laquelle, d'ailleurs, je veux développer Electronica comme un projet parallèle par rapport à mes projets studio. C'est justement de pouvoir justement collaborer avec des gens avec qui je n'ai pas eu l'occasion de collaborer jusqu'à maintenant. En dehors de ça, nous avons parlé de. J'ai aussi parlé aussi du prix des applications. Je pense que je l'avais pas couvert dans la dernière séquence en français. Il y a eu des réflexions de savoir est-ce que pendant les moments de confinement, l'appli pourrait pas être gratuite, etc. Donc je voulais en profiter pour, puisqu'il y a eu des questions là-dessus, pour dire que vous connaissez mon implication, mon engagement par rapport à la valeur de la création, et que je trouve assez indécent qu'en fait, finalement, on trouve tout à fait normal de se payer un t-shirt à 60 ou 80 euros ou une paire de tennis à 100 euros, qui en fait souvent sont fabriqués à un prix qui ne dépasse pas 2 ou 3 euros, c'est-à-dire le coût de fabrication est souvent de quelques euros, et on trouve ça tout à fait normal. Mais en revanche, quand il y a une appli qui coûte 9,99 € ou 15,99 € ou autre, d'un seul coup, on se dit « mais c'est beaucoup trop cher », etc. Ce que je trouve absolument choquant, dans la mesure où développer une appli, par exemple, comme développer un album, comme faire un film, ça prend des mois de travail avec des gens qui travaillent jour et nuit, qui n'ont pas l'ambition nécessairement de gagner de l'argent, mais simplement de vivre décemment avec ce qu'ils font. Et qu'au bout d'un moment, moi, je trouve que c'est tout à fait indécent de penser que bah, tout ça doit être gratuit, tout simplement parce qu'on peut, télécharger instantanément une appli ou un plugin. On se dit, bah, finalement, instantanéité s'accompagne finalement d'une valeur diminuée. Je pense qu'au contraire, il faut se féliciter d'avoir des génies qui nous facilitent la vie, qui font des applis, par exemple, dans le monde des applis absolument extraordinaires en permanence et qui nous facilitent la vie et qui sont révolutionnaires. Et je pense que la création n'a pas de prix. Et si on doit lui mettre, et si on doit en mettre un, il faut qu'il soit décent, et il faut qu'il corresponde à la valeur de ce qu'on va utiliser. Et je compte sur vous pour justement propager cette bonne parole sur le monde du net, parce que moi je suis de plus en plus choqué pour voir qu'il est tout à fait normal d'avoir des choses gratuitement, et dès qu'on demande justement un prix un peu décent par rapport à ce qui est fait, il y a des protestations que je trouve absolument inacceptables. Voilà. Indépendamment de ça, on a parlé effectivement des sorties live et notamment des sorties des anciens concerts. Les anciens concerts, on est en train d'en discuter, c'est dans le pipeline avec Sony pour les autres, pour les concerts qui sont partie du catalogue, je dirais les concerts de Houston, etc., d'Égypte, tout ça. Donc ça se fera à un moment donné. Mais avant, je voudrais cette année mettre un peu l'accent sur justement ce que j'ai fait récemment en live, que ça soit Electronica, que ça soit ce que j'ai fait récemment avec Alula. On a des documents visuels absolument incroyables et j'ai vraiment envie de mettre là-dessus, de mettre là-dessus d'abord. Et ça m'amène à une autre réponse que j'ai pu faire en anglais sur les concerts. Oui, je viendrai en Turquie, en Amérique du Sud, dans tous les pays où, effectivement, vous me demandez si je vais venir chez vous, et ce qui est bien normal. Il faut se dire qu'une tournée mondiale, ça se monte, c'est compliqué à monter, et que forcément, il y a des choix qui doivent être faits. Et que bien entendu, j'ai envie de venir en Turquie, j'ai envie de venir vous voir en Australie, de revenir en Amérique du Sud, d'aller en Asie, en Corée du Sud, au Japon, en Corée du Nord aussi, que ce soit en Afrique, que ce soit dans tous les pays qui me demandent de venir. Et donc, oui, bien sûr, je viendrai. Je viendrai peut-être pas en 2020, mais en 2021, j'espère pouvoir avoir l'occasion de venir vous voir. Voilà. Et que vous puissiez aussi venir m'entendre.
Peut-être juste un dernier petit mot pour la Jarre Family qui fête ses 10 ans cette année.
Alors, effectivement, un petit mot sur la Jarre Family qui fête ses 10 ans. Bon anniversaire, la Jarre Family. Vous pouvez imaginer que, ayant moi-même ma propre Jarre Family chez moi, d'avoir une Jarre Family à l'extérieur qui me suit de manière aussi fidèle et de manière aussi profonde et affectueuse et amicale, et quelque chose qui me touche beaucoup. J'en profite en plus pour vous remercier tous à travers le monde de me suivre avec autant d'assiduité. C'est quelque chose qui est extrêmement important pour tous les artistes et pour moi en particulier. Et je veux dire qu'on ne le dit pas assez, mais sans vous, je n'existerais pas. En tout cas, je n'existerais pas de la même manière. Et dans ces moments de confinement où on se retrouve un peu isolé, on est un peu tout seul, je pense que ça fait du bien pour les uns et pour les autres de pouvoir justement passer un moment comme ça, vous dire que je pense à vous dans des moments qui sont compliqués, où effectivement les gens sont malades, les gens sont inquiets, et c'est quelque chose qui me touche de pouvoir vous le dire en direct. Et puis là, je vais passer effectivement, comme vous tous, mes prochaines semaines en confinement. Et j'espère que ce sera l'occasion pour justement travailler sur la musique, trouver de nouvelles idées. J'ai plein d'idées avec ces nouveaux instruments que j'ai envie de travailler dessus. Vous savez, ce que j'explique dans mon livre, que certains ont lu, quand je commence un projet, j'aime bien avoir un nouvel objet, quel qu'il soit. Ça a toujours été un petit peu le cas. Ce qui est pas d'ailleurs, ce qui est un peu idiot, parce que je pense qu'on peut, c'est pas du tout obligatoire, mais enfin voilà, c'est un peu une sorte de toc. Et je donc voilà, j'ai une pensée pour vous. Et je disais aussi que ce projet Éon, c'est un projet qui c'est une musique qui se réinvente et se renouvelle après 2 semaines, après 4 semaines, après 6 semaines, après et même au-delà. Et d'une certaine manière, c'est un peu Éon, c'est un peu l'électro de confinement. Donc je trouve que c'est assez adapté aujourd'hui à la manière dont on vit, c'est de pouvoir avoir à un moment aussi où l'Internet, la vitesse, le débit d'Internet est réduit, où l'Internet est saturé, parce qu'il y a plein de gens qui s'en occupent, les étudiants qui l'utilisent et les gens pour leur travail. Donc Éon est finalement un bon moyen. Je ne suis pas en train de faire l'article là, mais je dis simplement que c'est vrai que c'est objectivement une manière comme quand on écoute un album sur une platine, mais de pouvoir justement écouter une musique, mais qui, elle, est en constante évolution, comme vont être les prochaines journées que nous allons passer. Voilà, donc j'espère que vous avez passé un bon moment. Moi, j'ai passé un très bon moment en votre compagnie. Merci de tous ces témoignages d'amitié, d'intérêt. Et ça continue, ça continue, ça continue. Malheureusement, je ne peux pas répondre à toutes les questions, mais je vais toutes les lire. Et s'il y a des questions qui appellent des réponses que je n'ai pas faites, je vous les communiquerai dans les jours qui viennent sur les réseaux habituels. Voilà. Thank you all. I was just saying that I'm really moved by all these hundreds and hundreds of questions you are asking me, and it's very important, I think, for any artist, but for me anyway, to have such a following and to have so many questions of yours. And partly in these days where we are isolated at home, where in lots of countries we can't go out, and it's hard, as some people are sick. So I have, of course, lots of thoughts to all of you. I think the beauty of internet and of modern technology is actually we are not totally isolated, because we can be together at the moment. And so take care of yourself. Be careful. I mean, take all the regulations in your country, in your different countries, very seriously, because it's not a joke, this fucking virus. And we are going to win if we take care of ourselves. And I love you all. Take care of yourself, and talk to you soon. Bye bye, guys and girls.